back with Beanie Feldstein. We showed the clip before the first conversation we were having, and a very active clip. A lot more unkind than I know you to be in real life.
Right?
Yeah.
I have sort of like a stuffed animal gummy bear personality, and Suki does not. You do not want to meet her.
Is in law enforcement.
Oh, yeah.
And I feel like maybe in that scene, those guys walked in and maybe assumed you'd be a little bit more gummy bear.
Right?
A little bit less Suki.
And they were caught off guard.
This is Ethan Coen, one of the Coen brothers, co-wrote this film.
Yes.
And the Coen brothers have some of the best women in law enforcement history, right? We have Holly Hunter from Raising Arizona, and of course, Frances McDormand from Fargo. So you're entering.
Bow down to
them. A very nice pantheon of people.
I cannot believe it. I mean, if you get a script from one of the Coen brothers,
yes,
it's like, I'll play a tree. Like, I don't care what I'm doing. But when I got the audition and it was like to play a cop, it just has that special kind of, I don't know, and to be in the lineage of those women is surreal. And then it's Ethan Coen and his wife, Trisha Cook, and together they've created this, like, everything you know and love about the Coen brothers, like that tone, that really specific, comedic, funny, action, quirky, raunchy tone. But then Trisha brought this super, like, queer female empowerment side to it. And to play one of their cops is, like, absolutely surreal. And it was so fun for me to just be angry all the time.
You have to get it out somewhere.
Just bitter and angry.
You had, there's a very big breakup scene early in the film. And which is also really funny, and it must have been very cathartic to do.
It was very cathartic. Margaret Qualley, the brilliant Margaret Qualley and Geraldine, they are the two leads of the film. And the impetus of them going away on this road trip is that Margaret and I were dating and she breaks up with Suki, my character. And they have to decide what to do with their belongings, two important ones being a wall dildo and a chihuahua named Alice. And in the scene, I'm hysterically crying because she's broken up with me. And then they hand me a power tool to take the wall dildo off the wall. And then the scene says that, you know, the dog is barking the whole time. And so I'm hysterically crying. And I'm like, take the dog, please take the dog. And so I have the power tool. I'm face to face with the wall dildo. Uh-huh. And the dog is supposed to be barking. And we could not get this dog to bark. It would not bark. So Ethan finally is like, to the trainer, like, do anything you need to do on this earth to get this dog to bark. I don't care about what Beanie's doing. I just need the visual of her with the dog in the background. Talk over her, do whatever you need to do. He was like, Bean, just look like you're, you know, sobbing and we'll get the dog. So he calls action and I start crying towards the dildo. And Ethan says action and the trainer goes, Bruiser, where is Elle Woods? And the dog starts barking. And the trainer, who's like a guy in his 50s, adopts this sorority girl voice and he's like, Bruiser, tell me one more time, where is Elle Woods? My lip, I've never tried so hard in my, it was the best acting I've ever done, not to laugh. And they call cut and we're all like, truly doubled over, we're laughing so hard. And it turns out that Ricky the dog, he played Bruiser on the Elle Woods of the Legally Blonde tour for about 5 years.
Oh my God.
And he responds more to Bruiser than he does to his own name. And the trainer, oh my God, it was one of the funniest moments of my whole life.
I feel like the trainer, when he's driving with the dog to set, is just begging him, like, please don't make me do sorority voice.
Don't make me do it in front of Ethan Coen.
Please don't make me do the Elle Woods bit, please. I'm begging you.
And Ricky's like, ha ha ha.
No, you're gonna have to call me Bruiser.
Oh my God. It's like his little king. So funny.
Congrats on the film.
Thank you.
Congrats on the marriage.
Thank you
for being back.
I'm so happy to be here.
You guys, Beanie Feldstein, Drive Away Dolls, Speeds in the Theaters, February 23rd. We'll be right back with Ben Mendelsohn.